Luckily, he had the coat to protect him from the biting cold. The cold seemed to be more brutal here than anywhere else. It seeped into bones and into every breath to get to the heart until it stopped. Carl needed to be dressed in warm clothes to survive. Another instance of this magic ice. What was this one doing, lying on the ground, so afraid? The plot thickened like water into ice. He had been running in fear from something creeping towards him, against which he couldn't do anything, only to end up like this, petrified and cold. It seemed as though Regin had been ready to take up arms and slay people like Hamilton. Could he have committed murder for his cause? Who could have gotten killed in front of his very eyes? Suddenly felt observed. He was worried about a presence around him. No stone can withstand the force of dynamite.
Thank you.
Carl's scout training was buried deep in his memory. What do you need again to start a fire? It was a typical shack, just like the ones you hear about in Quebecois legends. Local lumberjacks used it to rest and twice a day heat up their pea soup. Who quits a game one step away from victory? The leftover food, the clothes, the general warmth of the place, no evidence of escape. Carl was sure of it. People were here not long ago, and they expected to come back. cabin A, small but cozy, the perfect place to warm up. Crossbow bolts had the same origin. Carl was sure of it. Who was it? And more importantly, what was being hunted like this? Cabin B, lots of space, no windows. Hopefully its users aren't prone to dementia. Without a single window to brighten things up, the inside of the cabin was almost pitch black. Beware of close encounters of knee and furniture. Everything was set up for a well-deserved snack. It seemed like the place hadn't been empty for long, but without knowing exactly why, Carl had the feeling no one was coming back anytime soon.
Solitaire, a card game only hermits can truly enjoy. Carl felt depressed at the thought of playing this. Thank you. never thought he would be dancing with the wolves.
Thank you.
A wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty. When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot. The spirograph amused Carl. It was a nice modern toy. Aside from being repetitive by nature and completely useless, still, it found its way into many Quebecois homes. The key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Couche et Fils. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts. Money in a jar. What a shame. Carl would have loved cookies. Hay stub for some undoubtedly harsh lumberjack work. Alexandre Blais felled trees and chopped woods for Cloutier et Fils. Picture had been taken inside the house. It was the same wallpaper. Judging by the smiles, nobody suspected the impending misfortunes. Little Martin Blais with a family member. There was some resemblance between them, and Carl took note of the sense of bonding and pride they projected. Thank you. Well, looks like someone woke up on the wrong side of the bed. A window left open in that weather? Perhaps something had to be watched. The sheets were in such a way that indicated a rude awakening, followed by a hurried escape. What had happened here? The coals were still warm. Someone must have been stirring them up. A key. What could it be for? The garden shed? Carl couldn't reach it with his arm alone, but he had more than a few tricks up his sleeve to pick it up.